Hi, I'm Skylar. Welcome to Tech Edge. Today, we're diving back into the wonderful and ever-evolving world of USB to talk about USB-C, what it is, what it does, and how it quite literally fits into the tech landscape. Let's get plugged in. Originally announced in 2012, USB-C, which had previously been called USB Type-C, refers to the physical shape of the connector and port of the newest standard to join the universal serial bus family. We covered USB specification generations in a previous video, so if you have questions about USB 3.2 or USB 4, be sure to check that out with the link in the description or click the iCard here. While USB-C has been positioned as the new port standard going forward, still the most common and familiar USB connector shape is USB-A. This thin, rectangular connector gained popularity in the mid-90s and has a distinct top and bottom, requiring cables and devices to be oriented correctly in order to be plugged in, a much maligned design feature. USB-A also comes in mini and micro varieties that are used on a wide range of electronics. Then there's USB-B, which is somewhat less common, but is electrically identical to USB-A. USB-B connectors, which are more square in shape, are frequently used on printers, though they can also be found on some monitors and USB hubs. Mini USB-B and micro USB-B connectors, like their USB-A counterparts, can also be found on various devices. So that brings us to USB-C, which is oval, symmetrically shaped, and reversible, meaning there is no wrong way to plug it in. USB-C is intended to supplant the other existing USB form factors and provide a future-proof, fully featured option for hardware designers and users to standardize on. Now that said, while USB-C ports are becoming more and more common on mobile devices and consumer hardware, there is nothing universal about USB right now. As of making this video, USB-C has been in the news recently, with European Union pursuing legislation to mandate a single standard for charging and data ports on electronics. Their goal is to cut down on user confusion and minimize e-waste by eliminating the need for so many chargers and cables of differing connections. USB-C has been proposed as that unifying port standard. USB-C offers a range of advantages over its alphabetical predecessors. It can simultaneously provide and receive power, data, and video, making it ideal for connecting to a huge range of devices. Charging is also possible in both directions and at an impressive rate. With the release of USB-C specification revision 2.1, USB-C ports are able to deliver up to 240 watts of power, provided the devices and cables being used can accommodate that kind of juice. USB-C also enables data transfer speeds up to 40 gigabits per second, where the USB-A connectors max out at 10 gigabits per second. So, what's the holdup? Why isn't USB-C on every single device? In the industrial computing space, it comes down to the pace of change. The industrial computer market is just beginning to dabble with integrating USB-C into the latest generation of hardware. Even in the consumer space, there are still a lot of devices and peripherals that rely on USB-A connections to ensure they can interface with the equipment that users already have. And other manufacturers are holding strong to their own proprietary interfaces, insisting that a single port standard would actually slow the pace of innovation. So while there are signs that one port to rule them all may be coming, we are not there just yet. Hopefully this helps clear up a bit of the alphabet soup related to USB. If you still have questions, drop them in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like and be sure to subscribe so you don't miss future episodes. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on Tech Edge.